Hop One! That's not an insult. This is the Hop One. The Hop One? The Hop One Hot Rod that was in the Crew One and is now. Well, it's not now, it's always been back. But it's been here since the beginning. But I really want to customize it because people have told me that the customization. Oh, the customization. Apparently, it's the holy grail of customization in the Crew 2. And you know I'm about customization. I've got some meaty wangs, got some big venti bits. It's the one for me. And it's only 100,000 if you want to buy it yourself. So, oh, I think I feel like going like classic Majee. Let's go with a white classic clean Majee. Changing the wheels. You can put skulls on it and ruin it if you like. Let's put the wheels on the go. They're supposed to go on it. That's it. That's the way it's supposed to be. Stock. We may change our minds on that, you see. I think this thing's going to be really slow at the beginning. Oh! It sounds pretty good, though. Yep. It's just wheel spins and no power whatsoever. The quality of the lights is downright disgusting. But hey, it's a big meaty muscle that needs some love and attention. As you can tell, when it turns, the wheels turn much further than the actual car turns itself. That's called understeer, my friend. And understeer is bad. We will change that when I max this thing out as well. You thought we were just going to stop at that? The visuals, please. What do you take me for? Now, just to announce, I have purchased my next car. It's here. You're not gonna know what it is. I promise you, it's a good one. You're gonna see it super soon. I promise you. It will be this week that I will be announcing my next car. I've been dropping teasers on my Twitter. If you want, well, I'm about to drop even better teasers, but I've been dropping some teasers on my Twitter. Come there if you want to see it. But anyway, let's get customizing the Hop One next. That looks pretty sweet. Adding a load of vents and exhaust bits. That's exactly what the doctor ordered. But I know that this thing has a lot of options. Okay, let's just plain on switch the whole car exactly completely. It's completely different. Apparently, this is the best though. I'm expecting better than this. Give me, oh my God, that's stupid. This is even more stupid. Give me the vent and the air. Give me both. Why are you not going to give me both? Because it's not realistic thing. I don't care. It's the Hop One. Okay. I think I'm actually going to go and throw on. Should we go with like a semi-clean? Let's go semi-clean and whack on this boy here. This boy. We got 63 front bumpers to customize here. I've missed doing old customization videos. I have not done one properly in this game other than accepting normal videos. So we're doing a proper build here. And the DLC, obviously, I did the DLC. So I was like, you know, I need to do more of these. This is literally like that Ford thing. That Ford thing that is on Need for Speed, except it has more customization. It has more options. It has more stupidness. Look at the flat grill that's gonna barge people out the way and tell them that you're a big'un. There's just loads. I know there's a lot of repeating ones, but there's a lot of like switching options that you can use all different combinations. It would be nicer if, oh my, what is that? It's just American. It would be nice if you could select each part individually. That would probably be better personally, because sometimes there are some mix and matches that I would prefer, but they ain't there. So I actually like this grill here. I think that looks naughty. 41. That's the one I'm going with. Wheels are under the ground currently, but that's okay. We can actually change the wheels to look pretty sweet. We can make them like the classic style because they're staying the classic style with the tires. But we can make the modern style rims as well. That would be pretty sweet. I haven't actually done any of the stupid rims on this game. There's some really stupid ones, but that I'm not even going to call stupid. That looks incredible. Pick the, oh my God, pick the size as well. You know what? I'm going to go with this and then the back. I'm going to go two down. That looks incredible. I love it. Side mirrors, only two options. We can put old ones on or new boys. We're going to new boys. Rear fenders as well. Let me zoom out, please. I want to see more. I'll zoom out. We've got some big fender. What is that? It's just stupid. I love it. Let's go with this big boy here and the rear wing. There's only three options, but they're pretty decent. I was expecting a little bit nicer. That's pretty cool, though. I'll go with that rear one right there. And then the rear bumper. Ooh, nice classic look. Nice race car look. It's made an extra wing out of the trunky thing. Crew 2 plate on the back. That was a pretty sweet addition there. There's going to be a, hopefully some. Oh, yeah, there we go. We're starting to get a bit of a difference now. If you look at the bottom, we got some meaty exhaust going. Double exhausts. See, I want more customization. Give me more cars with crazy customization. Make it one of the special cars that you unlock from grinding out the game. That would be fantastic. I would love that. So, actually, stock it has those exhausts. I didn't even realize. Let's go back to the big ones that we saw. The big chain. Yes. Yes. It looks stupid, and I love it. Let's take out the back. No. 15. 15 it is. There's a lot of customization on this. Red interior. I'm going to go with the second option and the first option and change the interior to a little bit of carbon. Oh, I'm going to go with the black. This is super fresh. This is a fresh build. All the customization options are complete, but look at the state of that in a good way, though. Okay. Livery time. Oh, that is sweet. I was wanting to stick with the white idea, the white and the red on the interior, but that is almost too nice to pass. We got some nice flames on the front as well, if we want to go with that. We got a lot of nice subtle designs to accent the amazing design, of the bodywork on this whip. What's this? Heaven or hell? Thank you very much. How about the generic teeth that you can't see because I have so much meat all over my car? You can't see it on this either. I think I like the red design right at the beginning. That was really, really nice. Pepsi. Bit of Pepsi if you want it. No. Okay. Seriously, though, I think my favorite is going to be the first option right here. It just looks so too nice to pass up on. I can see why it is the number one option. I mean, it's still got some white on the back to match the wheels. It's all balanced. It's all good. The interior is still a little bit white. But obviously, it's all well and good doing it visually and it making look. It's the Ricermobile right now. But how about we whack in some 280 parts? Because if we throw these in, it's going to look the business and drag the business. Because we know it's a little bit weak in terms of the performance being this. But hey, we're now maxed out. 280, hop off. Yep. It even sounds meatier. Did it actually change or did I just not pay attention the first time? Woohoo! All right, let's go down the mountain. Probably my favorite road to go. Got a bit of wheel spin going on. I think I have traction control off, so that he stuck behind a barrier. That wing is amazing. It's totally in the way of absolutely everything. Unless you go on this view right here. Look at that. That view is absolutely perfect. Thank you so much for being a thing. But look at the grip. You wouldn't believe this thing has got this much grip. Normally, if you saw this thing, you think, oh, it's got these old granddad tires, it's gonna be sliding everywhere. We got some trouble with understeer. We got some teething issues. Let's have a look in the performance tuning. What have I got set up already? So we got the traction off, ESP off, slide helm off. Good. That's a good start. That's what I've been putting on pretty much every build. We've got 520 horsepower if you wanted to know a stat. That's pretty sweet. Tire grip, aero distribution, put more at the rear. It should help us slide a little bit more. But it means the front should lose it a little bit more. Let's have a gander around this. Oh! How about we make a drifting machine and then it fails to change gear itself because it's like, nah. You shouldn't be doing that. Hop one, more like, wait, I just realized there's exhaust on the side and on the back. Why not? There's some exhaust options on here. Do you guys have like a million exhausts? Okay, not literally, but there are closer to a million than zero, so therefore it is close to a million. Hello! Are you mesmerized by the appearance of my hop one? It's actually amazing. I was gonna go with the big intake at the front, but come on. I like the intakes at the side like that. This just looks so... It looks so perfect for this car because it looks like it's been pieced together randomly. They're like, yes, that will do, but it's gonna perform like an absolute god. And surely... It does. It does actually perform pretty well. I'm actually surprised at how stable this feels. I was expecting it to be a little bit slip and slidey, especially with traction and ESP off and stuff, but I guess we got some nice aero bits with the upgrades apparently, because it's not driving badly at all. I have no visibility whatsoever. That's a jump into the water. Hop one into the drink. You know, I need to do a speed test. I know you've probably already seen the stat, but I didn't even look. I didn't even consider looking. I don't know why. I'm an absolute mong, apparently. But let's test the top speed of the hop one. I want to give it a go. This has been fun. I've missed customize. I don't know why I haven't done the customization very much on this game. I should have done it much more. I feel like I'm losing traction a lot. I almost feel like I should put traction back on for this speed test. But nah, it's all right. We got it. We got the stability. Stability is on. It's not actually on, but we're gonna pretend it is. That's something to hit. Thank God I went through it. Feel like I'm gonna run out of turf before. It's not the fastest car. It's definitely not. It is literally hopping. The hopping hop one. All right, I'm gonna cheat. I'm gonna have a look at the actual performance of this thing. We have got ourselves 226 miles an hour, which means it's decently fast, but it's definitely not the fastest. That, my friends, was the hop one, and I'm excited about so many things this week. I'm top of the world. If you have any ideas what you think my next car is going to be, leave them down in the comments. I'll see how close you get when it actually gets revealed. But be sure to smash like, subscribe if you are new, and let me know if you want to see more builds like this in the future, because the hop one is hopping great, mate. Buy it. Peace.